James Mattis shut down Obama's deep state's sick plan to hijack Trump's presidency. Ever since Donald Trump declared himself a candidate for president, the deep state has been gunning for him. Rogue agents in the CIA and FBI set in motion a conspiracy to destroy Trump. These shadowy forces thought they had the upper hand, but James Mattis just shut down the CIA's sick plan to hijack Trump's presidency. The deep state figured they had Trump cornered. Trump made his alliance with Saudi Arabia the cornerstone of his Middle East policy. The administration courted the Saudis and the kingdom's heir apparent, Crown Prince Mohammed bin Salman, to help bring about a peace deal with Israel and to contain Iran. That did not sit well with Barack Obama's deep state. Obama wanted to make his alliance with the anti-American Iranian government the focal point of Middle East politics. He appeased Iran with his disastrous nuclear agreement that allowed them to acquire a nuclear weapon. Trump tore up Obama's Iran deal and Saudi Arabia supported the president's policy. So sinister forces within the US government retreated to their dark corners of power and plotted their revenge. They seized their moment when Saudi journalist Jamal Khashoggi walked into the Saudi consulate in Turkey under the impression he was to pick up papers for his impending marriage. He was killed by 17 Saudi agents. Khashoggi had been a critic of the Crown Prince and also a one-time member of the Muslim Brotherhood terrorist organization. He was also a contributor to the Washington Post. The Obama deep state echo chamber sprang into action. Anonymous leaks filled the papers with accounts of Saudi agents hacking Khashoggi to pieces with a bone saw. Deep state agents filled American papers with leaks about how the CIA's assessment of the situation was that the Crown Prince ordered Khashoggi's killing. This led to calls for the government to sanction the Crown Prince. Former Obama CIA Director John Brennan led the public charge. Brennan was one of the architects of using the fake news Christopher Steele Russia dossier to frame Trump for colluding with the Russians. He pounced on this opportunity to undermine Trump's foreign policy. Brennan tweeted, "Since Mr. Trump excels in dishonesty, it is now up to members of Congress to obtain and declassify the CIA findings on Jamal Khashoggi's death. No one in Saudi Arabia, most especially the Crown Prince, should escape accountability for such a heinous act. But that would be disastrous." Trump pointed out in an interview with the Washington Post that punishing the Crown Prince could push Saudi Arabia into the arms of China and Russia. "We have an ally that's investing billions and billions of dollars in our country. They could very easily invest $110 billion, $450 billion overall over a period of time, fairly short period of time. $110 billion in military. Russia and China would love to have those orders, and they'll get them if we don't. They'll have no choice, but they'll get them if we don't. So I take everything into consideration," and again, he totally denies it, and he denied it to me on three different occasions, on three different calls, and a lot of other people deny it, too. Did he do it? As I said, maybe he did and maybe he didn't. But in the meantime, Saudi Arabia's spending billions and billions of dollars in the United States, and I want them to spend it here. I don't want them to spend it in China and Russia," Trump told the Post. Trump explained in realpolitik terms why the Saudi alliance was in America's interest. Secretary of Defense James Mattis and Secretary of State Mike Pompeo then executed the second prong of Trump's plan to get his foreign policy back on track. And they shut down the deep state's leak campaign by telling the truth. Both reviewed all the intelligence, and both cabinet officials told reporters there was no smoking gun linking the Crown Prince to Khashoggi's murder. Mattis told reporters at the Pentagon that Trump's national security